Good morning, Ananda. Today we are discuss about the percentage reactance and short circuit MVA problems and how the reactors are to be constructed. Coming to the problem, okay, a power plant has three generating units. Okay, the power plant has three generator units. Okay, this is the generator 1 and this is the generator 2 and this is the generator 3. Okay, at 7500 kVA with 15% reactance. Okay, therefore, the three generators having the 7500 kVA and 15% reactance. Okay, therefore, the plant is protected by a tie bar system. Okay, that's why we are draw the tie bar system. Okay, this is the tie bar system. Okay, this is the generator 1 plant, generator 2 plant and generator 3 plant. Okay, each and every plant having the tie bar system. Okay, that's why we are drawing like this. The single line diagram are drawn like this. Okay, the tie bar system with a reactance rated at 7500 MVA and 66%. Okay, therefore, the reactance for that tie bar system is 7500 MVA and 6% reactance. Okay, this is the single line diagram, equivalent diagram for that tie bar system. Okay, equivalent diagram for the tie bar system and having the reactance value is 6% and 7500 is the MVA. Okay, understand ma? Next, determine the fault KVA. Okay, first we determining the fault KVA when the short circuit occurs on one of the section at the bus bars. Okay, if the short circuits are occur at the one of the section at the bus bars. Okay, next, if the reactors were not present, okay, if the reactors were not present, what would be the fault KVA? Okay, these two things are to be determined by using this given data. Okay, this is the single line diagram for that system. Okay, this is the generator 1, generator 2 and generator 3. Okay, each generator is having the tie bar systems. Okay, this is the tie bar 1, tie bar 2, tie bar 3. Therefore, each and every tie bar system having the reactance of 6% and 7500 MVA. Okay, then we draw the equivalent circuit reactance diagram. Okay, then we draw the equivalent circuit reactance diagram. Okay, first of all, tie bar system means we draw the equivalent reactance diagram. Okay, that is the reactance in series with the tie bar reactance value. Okay, this is the reactance in series with the tie bar. These three, all the generators, three generators are connected in parallel. That's why we draw the reactance diagram like this. Okay, in the question, first of all, we draw the reactance diagram. Okay, this is the equivalent reactance value for generator G1 and this is the tie bar system reactance and this is the equivalent reactance diagram for the generator G2 and this is the tie bar system reactance and this is the equivalent reactance diagram for the generator 3 and this is the tie bar system reactance. Okay, in the question, we are having the fault will be obtained at any bus bars. Okay, that means in between the generator and the tie bar system. Okay, first of all, we are obtaining the fault. Okay, this is the fault that will be obtained between the tie bar system to the generator. Okay, this is the percentage XG1. Okay, this is the percentage XG1. And this is the percentage XG2 and this is the percentage XG3. Okay, this is the equivalent reactance. Its reactance value is 15%, and tie bar reactance is 6%. Okay, therefore, first, we calculate the equivalent reactance for this diagram. Okay, in this case, 15% and 6% are connected in series. Okay, therefore it is the 21% and it is the 21%. Then these two 21% reactances are connected in parallel. Okay, then we find the equivalent reactance, that is 21 into 21 by 21 plus 21. Okay, that is equal to 10.5. Okay, this is the equivalent reactance for this generator 2, generator 3 and tie bar reactance. Okay, then 10 point, first we draw the, up to this point, we draw the equivalent reactance diagram. Okay, this is the single equivalent reactance diagram. Its value is 10.5. Its value is 10.5. And this is the reactance value for the generator G1. Okay, this is the fault that will be obtained at a point. Okay, its value is 15%. The reactance for the generator 1 is 15%. And this value is 6%. And this value is 6%. Okay, first. Okay, if the fault will be obtained at this point, then 6% tie bar reactance and equivalent reactance for this both the generators and tie bar system is 10.5. Both are connected in series. Okay, therefore 10.5 plus 6.1 is equal to 16.6%. Okay, this is the 16.6%. Then we draw the equivalent reactance diagram. Okay, therefore, the fault will be obtained at this point. This is 16.6 and this is 15.1%. If the fault will be obtained at this point, then these two reactances are connected in parallel. Okay, therefore, 16.5% and 15.1% are connected in parallel. Therefore, its equivalent reactance is 16.5 into 15. Okay, 16.5 into 15.1 by 16.5, not 5, not 6. 16.6 plus 15.1. Okay, then the equivalent reactance. Therefore, the overall reactance value is 7.85. Overall reactance value is 7.85. Okay, then we calculate the short circuit KVA. Okay, then we calculate the short circuit KVA. Okay, therefore, short circuit KVA is equal to base KVA by percentage X into 100. Okay, what is the formula for short circuit KVA? Base KVA by percentage X into 100. Okay, what is the base KVA? 7500 is the base KVA. Okay, therefore 7500 by percentage X. Okay, that is the percentage reactance or the equivalent reactance value, that is 7.85. Okay, into 100. Okay, then we obtain the short circuit KVA. Okay, therefore, short circuit KVA is equal to 95.46 MVA. Okay, therefore, short circuit KVA is equal to 95.46 MVA. Okay, first, we draw the single line diagram. After that, we will draw the reactance diagram. Then we simplify this reactance diagram. Okay, that will be obtained for single reactance. Okay, after finding that equivalent reactance value, okay, this is the equivalent reactance. Okay, after obtaining the percentage X value, then we obtain the short circuit current. For any circuit, for any single line diagram, first we will find out the equivalent reactance diagram. And then we determining the equivalent percentage reactance. Okay, this is the percentage reactance, equivalent percentage reactance for the given single line diagram. After determining the percentage X, then we determining the short circuit KVA. Okay, what is the formula for short circuit KVA? MVA by base MVA by KVA percentage x. Okay, base MVA by percentage x into 100. Okay, what is the base MVA? 7500 by percentage x is 7.85 into 100. Percentage x is 7.85 into 100. Okay, then we obtain the short circuit KVA. Okay, therefore the short circuit KVA is 95.46 MVA. 95.46 MVA. Okay, after determining the short circuit KVA, what is the second consideration and what is the second case? If the reactors were not present and would be the fault KVA. If the reactors does not obtained. Okay, the reactors means the tie bar reactants. Okay, therefore there is no tie bar reactants for the system. Then what is the short circuit MVA or the fault MVA? First we draw the equivalent reactance diagram for without tie bar reactants. Okay, for without tie bar reactants, first we draw the equivalent reactance diagram. Okay, this is the equivalent reactance diagram for no tie bar reactants. Okay, then these two are connected in parallel. Okay, therefore the equivalent reactance is 7.5. 15 into 15 by 15 plus 15, that is 7.5. Okay, therefore we draw the equivalent reactance diagram up to this point. Okay, this is the reactance for the generator G1. And this is the equivalent reactance for the generator G2 and the G3. Okay, this is the percentage XG1 value. And this is the equivalent reactance for XG2 and G3. Okay, that is equal to 7.5. And this is equal to 15%. Okay, therefore, 15% and 7.5. Therefore, 15% and 7.5 are connected in parallel. Then 7.5 into, find the equivalent reactance, 7.5 into 7.5 plus 15. Okay, this is the total equivalent reactance or the percentage X. Okay, this is the total equivalent reactants are the percentage X. Okay. Then we determining the short circuit MVA or the fault MVA. Okay, that is 5%. Then we determining the short circuit MVA. Short circuit MVA is equal to base MVA by percentage X into 100. Okay, short circuit MVA is equal to base MVA by percentage X into 100. Okay, what is the base MVA? 7500. Okay, base MVA is 7500 by percentage X. Okay, what is the percentage X value? That is 5%. Okay, 5 into 100. Okay, this is the short circuit MVA. Therefore, there is no tie bar reactance. Okay, this is the case 2. And this is the case 1, when the tie bar reactances are obtained, the fault will be obtained in between the generator, any one of the generator to the system. Okay, this is the two cases that determining the short circuit MVA or the fault MVA. Okay, next, the last topic in this unit is the construction of a reactors. How the reactors be constructed. Okay. Whenever a fault occurs in a power system, okay, whenever the fault occurs in a power system, large currents will be flows in the network, okay. If the any faults that will be obtained in the power system, therefore the large currents will be flows in the network. If the fault is dead short circuits at the terminals, okay, therefore the fault currents will be damaged, okay, the power system equipments. Okay, due to that fault currents, the overall power system equipments will be damaged. Okay, to limit the large current under these circumstances, the current limiting reactors are used. Okay, to limit the large currents, okay, to limit the large currents under these therefore we are using the current limiting reactors. Okay, based on the location of the reactors, okay, based upon the location of the reactors, okay, these are be classified as generator reactors, feeder reactors, and bus bar reactors. Okay, how, why you are using the reactors to limit the short circuit currents for a network? Okay, for reduction of the for protection of the various equipments in the power system, we are using the reactors, okay, that will be connected to the system or the networks. Okay, for connecting that reactors, okay, the react that will be classified into three types: generator reactor, feeder reactors, and bus bar reactors. Okay, again, these bus bar reactors are classified into two types, that is ring systems and the tie line systems. Okay, therefore the bus bar reactors are classified into two types, that is ring systems and the tie line systems. Okay, these are the various classifications for the reactor, and the based upon their connection of the reactors in the network or the systems. Okay, first coming to the generator reactor. Okay, in these reactors, the reactors are placed in series with each of the generators. Okay, in this case, okay, these reactors are connected in series to the generator. Okay, this is the voltage source for generator G1, and this is the voltage source for generator G2, and this is the voltage source for generator G3. Okay, for protection of the various equipments in the power system, we are connecting the reactors in series to the generators like this. Okay, this is the bus bar. Okay, in that bus bar, each and every generator, we are connecting the reactors for protecting the overload currents. Okay, due to these reactors, the fault currents from the generator is limited. Okay, by using these reactors, the fault currents from the generator is limited. Okay, that's why we are using the reactors that will be connected into the generators. Okay, for that reason, we are calculating the each and every single line diagram for the network. Okay, we are calculating the equivalent reactance diagram and the reactance values. Okay, that will be observed in the various problems. And what are the main disadvantages for connecting these reactors? Okay, when the fault occurs at the feeder, it may cause the changes in the voltages at remaining healthy feeders and also may lose synchronism. Okay, if the faults occur at any one of the feeder, okay, therefore there is a changes in the voltages. Okay, therefore the remaining healthy feeder is affected for the due to the fault obtained in that generator. Okay, therefore this is a constant voltage drop in the reactors. Okay, this is the constant voltage drop in the reactors, and also the power losses are occur even during normal operating conditions. Okay, therefore the power losses is also obtained during the normal conditions. Okay, these are the some of the disadvantages that will be obtained when we are connecting the reactors in series to the generators. Next type of reactor connection is the feeder reactors. Okay, next type of reactor connection is the feeder reactor. Okay, what is meant by feeder reactor? Okay, what is meant by feeder reactor? Okay, in this method, the protection of each feeder is equipped with a series reactor. Okay, in this type of feeder reactor method, the protection of each feeder. Why? Because we are using the reactor, it gives the protection for the feeder line. Okay, why? Because we are giving the protection. If any short circuit currents are obtained, more amount of currents that will be flowing through the feeder line. Okay, therefore automatically that line will be damaged. Okay, to limit that damages by using these reactors. Okay, it is equipped in series reactors. Okay, the event of a fault on any feeder, okay, the fault current drawn is restricted by the reactors. Okay, this is the generators G1, G2 and the G3. Okay, these are the bus bars. Okay, in this case, we are connecting the reactors. Okay, this is the feeder line. Okay, this is the feeder line 1, feeder line 2, feeder line 3. Okay, at that feeder line in series, we are connecting the reactors. Okay, this is the reactor for this feeder line. And this is the reactor for this feeder line, and this is the reactor for this feeder line. Okay, what is the equivalent reactance diagram for the feeder? That is single reactance that will be connected in series. Okay, understand ma? Why? Because we are using that feeder line to reduce the high currents flowing through the short circuit current flowing through the feeder line. Okay, by using these reactors, okay, we limit the short circuit currents that will be flows through the feeder lines. Okay, what are the disadvantages are there when we are using the feeder reactors? Okay, what are the main disadvantages are there when we are using the feeder lines? Okay, therefore, the voltage drop and power losses still occurs in the reactor. Okay, the voltage drop and power losses still occur in the reactors. Okay, in the reactors, when we are connecting the feeders in series to the reactors, okay, therefore, some voltage drops that will be obtained. Okay, due to that voltage drops, okay, we are obtaining the some power losses. Okay. These feeder reactors do not offer any protection for the bus bar faults. Okay, when we are connecting the reactors in series to the feeder line, only it gives the protection for that feeder only. Okay, it does not give any protection for the bus bar. If any faults are obtained at this bus bar, there is no protection that will be given by this feeder react that does not give the feeder reactors. Okay, that is the main disadvantages when we are using the feeder reactors in series to the feeder. Only it gives the protection for that feeders. Next, last type of reactor is the bus bar reactor. Okay, last type of reactor is the bus bar reactor. In the both above method, the reactor carries the full load current. Okay, in this method, the reactor carries the full load current under normal operations. So it offers the constant voltage drops and power losses. Okay, under normal operating conditions, the current flowing through that reactor is constant. Okay, therefore, the voltage drops and the power losses is also constant. To avoid these power losses and the voltage drops, by dividing the bus bars into the sections. Okay, to reduce the power losses and the voltage drops in the bus bars, okay, the bus bars are divided into the number of sections and interconnected. Okay, the sections through the protective reactors are two types. Okay, how we will be divide and how we will be interconnected means by using the two connections. Okay, that is first one is the ring systems. Okay, that is first one is the ring system and second one is the tie bar system. Okay, these are the two methods for protecting the bus bars or for reducing the bus bar voltages and the power losses. Okay, by sections are the interconnected for that bus bars. Okay, we are using the two types of connections, that is the ring systems and tie bar system. Okay, first coming to the ring system. Okay, this is the schematic diagram for that ring systems. Okay, this is the bus bar reactors. Okay, in this method, each feeder is fed by one generator. Okay, in this ring main system, okay, each feeder, okay, this is the feeder 1, feeder 2, feeder 3. Okay, each feeder is protected by the each generator. So, very little power losses across the reactor during the normal operating conditions. So, we are obtaining the less power losses when we are using the separate feeders for the separate generators under normal operating conditions. Okay, therefore, under normal operating conditions, okay, we reduce the power losses or power flows occur during the normal operating conditions. Hence, the voltage drop and power losses are negligible. Okay, therefore, by using the each and every generator having the separate feeders, then we automatically reduce the power losses and it will be negligible. Okay, suppose if a fault occurs on any one of the feeder, only the generator to which feeder is connected will feed the faulted current. Okay, therefore only that feeder is affected and the remaining other feeders does not affected, and rest of the generators are required to feed the faulted through the reactors. Okay, that is the main reason for we are using the ring connection of bus systems. Okay, each and every section having the separate feeder and the reactor that will be giving the protection for that generators. Okay, suppose if any faults are obtained at any one of the feeder, then automatically other feeders does not disturb. Other feeders does not affected. Next, coming to the last type of that connection, that is the tie bar system. Okay, this is an improvement of over the ring systems. Okay, this is the advanced method for the ring main systems. Okay, in this system, the current fed into a faults. Okay, so therefore, if any faults are obtained, has to pass through the reactors, okay, which are connected in series between the sections. Okay, therefore, it requires an additional bus bar systems. Okay, suppose if any faults are obtained at that feeder or the reactor, okay, then we are requiring for that additional systems. Okay, like this. This is the reactor feeder reactor, and this is the tie bar connection. Okay, therefore, this is the advanced method for that ring main system. Okay, we are using the tie bar connection. Okay, by using this tie bar connection, a fault has to pass through the reactors, okay, which are connected in series between the systems. Okay, we are using the additional bus bar systems. Okay, therefore, we are using the additional bus bar systems. Okay, that is called as the tie bar system. Okay, Okay, by using that tie bar system, okay, we continue the power supply, and then there is no damages for the system. Why? Because means we are using the another connection, okay, that is the tie bar connection for that generator feeder line or the reactor feeder line. Okay, this is the basic advantages for the uses of the various types of the reactors. Depending upon the reactor connection, okay, what is the main use of that reactor? We reduce the short circuit currents of the line. Okay, when we are using the reactors in series to the generators or the feeders or the bus bars, okay, we are limiting the short circuit currents or the MVA currents. Okay, for reducing that short circuit currents, we are using the reactors for each and every equipment, that is the generator reactor, feeder reactor, and the bus bar reactors. Okay, therefore, depending upon the section of that bus bars, okay, we are using the ring sections and the tie sections. Why? Because we are using the sectionalizing that bus bars. Okay, we are reducing the voltage drops and the power losses. Okay, by using these two different connection of that bus bars reactors, okay, we are easily reducing the voltage drops and the power losses. Okay, without sectionalizing the bus bars, okay, we are obtaining the more power losses and the more voltage drops. Okay, that's why we are using the different two types of connection methods for the bus bar reactors, that is ring systems and tie line systems. Okay, the tie line system is advanced method for the ring systems. Okay, these are the various types of reactors that will be connected to the generators, feeders, and also the bus bars. Okay, this is the connection diagram for that generators. and this is the connectional reactor diagram for that feeders, and this is the connectional diagram for the ring main, ring bus bar system reactors, and this is the another connection diagram for that tie bar reactors. Okay, understand ma. Basically in the fourth unit, okay, we are calculating the short circuit KVA or the faulted MVA ratings. Okay, before going to calculating the short circuit KVA or the MVA ratings, first we draw the single line diagram for the given data. After that, we are drawing the reactance diagram. Then we calculate the equivalent reactances, equivalent reactance value for the network. Okay, and then we are calculating the short circuit KVA or the short circuit MVA easily. And these are the various types of the bus bar reactors. That already seen in the problems also. Okay, we continue in the next class.